Hello friends, in this video we are going ahead and we'll look into the Oracle managed file transfer, that is Oracle MFT. So this Oracle MFT is a new tool which has been introduced in Fusion Middleware 2 to 3 years back, in which provide us the very easy way to exchange and manage our files within internal and external parties. So it is mostly used for file transfer between you can do a SFTP, FTP, or you can use SOA or OSB. You can invoke MFT using SOA or OSB, and then you can do the file transfer. So today we'll go ahead and we'll see how to install and configure an MFT, Oracle managed file transfer domain, and how to do the installation and configuration. So right now let me go ahead and show you. For Oracle MFT we need two softwares, that is one will be Weblogic and another is the MFT software. So I have downloaded both the software, so let me show you. Here I have the mft.jar file. So this is the MFT product. So I am using the version 12.2.1.2, if I am using this 12.2.1.2 version of MFT, then I have to install the same version of Weblogic as well. So here is my Weblogic installer. So this is fmw21.2.infrastructure.jar file. So first thing is we have to install Weblogic, then we have to install MFT product on it. You can also club together MFT product with SOA component, but here right now in this video I am going ahead and I will be creating a standalone MFT environment which will be used for file transfers. So first thing is we have to install our Fusion Weblogic. So as we know that it 12.2.1.2 uses 1.8 version of JDK, so I am using the same. So this is my I will be doing the Weblogic installation. So you can use java-jar, and this is the location where my JDK is present, that is 1.851 version of JDK. So if you use 1.7 version of JDK with 12.2.1.2 version, in that case it will throw a error message, or not, it will show you a warning message that it is not a recommended one. So that is why you should use 1.8 version of JDK with your 12.2 version of installers. So this is my Oracle Fusion Middleware 12c infrastructure installation. It is a Weblogic installation which we are going to do 12.2.1.2, and let me minimize this. I will click on next, skip auto updates. Here I have to give the location where I will be installing my Weblogic. I will be installing in Oracle OMFT Oracle. So this is my location where I will be installing, and this is my Oracle home. Then I will press next. And the Fusion Middleware infrastructure without example, I don't write right now, need example. It will check my operating system and Java version, and if everything is correct it will show me a green tick mark. If the versions are not correct, then it will show me an error message. So if there is any error message, please don't proceed further. First check that error message and rectify that error message, and then only you should proceed further. So I don't want to receive any email updates from Oracle right now. So I will be removing this checkbox, and this is the complete package which will be installed. So now it will take me around another 5 minutes to do this installation. So this is my Weblogic installation, which I will be using it for MFT. So once the Weblogic is installed, I will install MFT product on this. So it took around 5 minutes to complete this installation. So my Weblogic has now been installed. So I will click on next, and I will click on finish. So my Weblogic server has been installed. Now my next thing is to install the MFT. So I will go ahead and install MFT now. So v779240 1, so this is my mft.jar file. So now I have to use Oracle JDK bin java hyphen jar, same version of fmw 12.2.1.mft.jar. so now it will install MFT product on my Weblogic. So again, it is doing the same check of my operating system, and if it is able to, if the initial checks are successful, then it will move ahead. So now I will, it is the Oracle Fusion Middleware 12.2.1.2, same version of the Weblogic, and the same version of MFT have to be used. So before you can see here, before proceeding, ensure that you have installed Oracle Fusion Middleware Infrastructure 12c. So you have to make sure that your Fusion Middleware Infrastructure 12c is already installed, then only you go ahead and install your managed file transfer. So now I will press next. I will press next, skip. Here I have to give the location where my Weblogic has been installed. So MFT Oracle will open, and then you can click on view. It will list down all the components which you have installed on your Weblogic. So I'll press next. It will again do the check of your system. Then you just have to do next and click on install, and then your MFT product will be installed on your Weblogic. So if you want to see, it will, this will not take much time, because it is a small software compared to your Weblogic. So it's, so this is you can see now here MFT is added here, and OSB, so all those components got added, and now you can see your MFT product has been successfully installed. 100% is done. You can press on next, and you can press on finish. So now in this I have installed Weblogic infrastructure, and I have installed MFT. In the next video, we'll go ahead and create an MFT domain and see what are the different functionalities of MFT and how easy it is to use MFT for any file transfer from one system to another system. You want to transfer file from HR system to your any other systems, you can do that. From EBS to some vendors, you can do that. It's really very easy. I will show you how can this be achieved.